I am an anthropologist. I study Homo sapiens. This is an actual fact. I'm not making this up. This is a backdrop to the song. How can you tell with your naked eye when a woman is at the most fertile period of her month? How can you tell with your naked eye?
She says so.
She could say so, but that's an audio cue. How can you tell visibly? But it's good. Every suggestion is a good one. Doesn't make a sign. Anybody? Anybody have an idea?
Boobies?
Oh, wrist.
Can't tell in your wrist, can't tell in the boobies. You can't tell at all. Because we are relatively rare amongst primates and mammals. We don't have any visible sign for when the female of the species is ovulating. Homo sapiens practice what is called concealed ovulation, which is kind of fascinating. So then it leads to a question. Why did we evolve this way? Okay, this is all important to understand the song. Two main hypotheses. We either evolved this way because it encourages pair bonding. It means you have to have more sex to procreate. If you don't know when you are most likely to procreate, it leads to more sex. More sex leads to an emotional pair bond, and so it is to facilitate monogamy, which has advantages for both the male and the female. And in fact, there are studies which show that when there are two parents in a household in small-scale societies, those with two parents have higher fecundity rates, and in that sense are more evolutionarily successful. So possibly because of monogamy. However, there's a thesis which says it was for monogamy, but then women sneak on the side, and this way they can get better genes from a more strapping man, the cuckoldry hypothesis. Now, the second twist on this is perhaps it happened because of polygamy. And this way, men would not know when they were more likely to have impregnated a woman, and they are not going to practice infanticide. They're not going to kill the youth. So that's the other sort of thing. Then there's some sad things. Maybe it happened because we're bipedal. We stand on our legs instead of being on all fours. If your genitals swell up, it's a lot easier to see if you're on all fours as opposed to on two. So that there's an idea that maybe it fell away. Now, how do you test for this? There are these academics. You can do some tests in the lab where you have people sort of look at photos and stuff. Those have their own sort of biases, self-selecting as who is on college campuses participating in studies. However, there are these scientists, 2003, University of New Mexico, what they do, they went to a strip club. 18 dancers, self-report for 2 months, 60 days, 296 shifts, 5,300 lap dances, and indeed, what do we see for the strippers who were not on the pill, who are ovulating? They get more tips according to their ovulatory cycle. When they are more fertile, they get more tips. For those who are on the pill, their tips were steady. And in fact, that is the first solid economic evidence which argues that there are non-visible signs that when we are ovulating. The broader category is called concealed ovulation, right? Yeah. Kind of amazing. Amazing, right? I mean, right, I'm telling you. You know this better than me. I don't even ovulate, and I think it's amazing. So I wrote a song about it because I love Homo sapiens, and I wanted to get back to the species. Yeah.
Female Homo sapiens has her ovulation for reasons that we're unsure of. We don't sexually signal bright pink when we mingle, which leads to us making more love. Yes, did this trait evolve so that men stay involved? Maybe get coupled in on the side. Still, the queer fact remains about sapiens, concealed ovulations. Alright, oh, concealed ovulations. Alright, can we sing that along? Oh, concealed ovulations. Alright, let's repeat it. Concealed ovulations. Alright,
relatively rare primates, concealed.
Look that out.
Concealed ovulations, all right.
What you love.